I need not tell you dreamers that the whole situation is very serious. That must be apparent, that must tell you. I think one difficult idea is that the problem is that such enormous complexity that the very mass of the radio make it exceedingly difficult for the man in the street to reach a clear situation. Furthermore, the people of this world are distant from the trouble areas of the earth, and it is hard for them to comprehend the plight and consequent reactions of the long suffering and the effect of those reactions on their governments in connection with our efforts with our peace in the world. The most important thing in the world today, in my opinion, is a spiritual generation which brings a feeling of good faith among men generally. Discouraged need of the inspiration of great people. Such a leadership can be rallied against intolerance, against distrust, against that fatality that leads to war. It is to be hoped that the democratic nations can provide the necessary leadership. The government, civil society, and donors combined to try to build an alternative system for spending public money. What may in fact be a utopian dream in that the development of cosmopolitan tolerance and mutual respect among sovereign and independent nations, subject to no higher political authority than themselves, will forever spur human civilization from a nuclear war for which the weapons are ready and waiting. The potential to build a better world is only visible if we believe change is around the corner. Let's export the welfare state to those who were born to live in eternal poverty. Let's eradicate disease and hunger once and for all. Let's start building a new world, the world of no diplomacy, the world without borders. The new architecture of capitalism is the beginning of the history of tomorrow. We will determine our own fate. We do not need Nostradamus or the next Nostradamus to dictate that the models predict the World War III. There will be no World War III if we defeat the axis of people. There will be no World War III if we embrace the extreme poverty environment. It is time to sound the urgency of our time. It is time to become men and women of political stature. Where are the disciples of Marshall and Schumann? Where are the disciples of Monet and Schumann? You will wake up. You will wake up. Will you conquer the America, friend? I believe in class mobility, in the reduction of inequality, in the abolition of extreme poverty, and in North-South cooperation. I anticipate changing times and take into account a horizontal world, making vertical progress in the maturity of ideas, one which discovers new dimensions of understanding and change based on persuasion and the transmission of excitement, an excitement that sees the world moving ahead on the path of sustainable economic growth. Sustainable growth will grant each citizen of the blue planet access to a basic welfare state and the opportunity to build up wealth and assets thanks to hard work and dedication.